And I remember going to the hospital when you were born. And so I remember going to the hospital, and I must have had a cold at the time. And the nurses wanted me to put on a mask. So, and I couldn't go onto the maternity ward until I had a mask on. And I pitched a fit, and I don't even know if I saw Kelsey. And I love that my first memory of being a sibling was, this is awful and I want to go home.
Hey, child, up and go. A big world is out there waiting for us to live in every day.
Kelsey spent a majority of her formative years playing volleyball. And when I say playing volleyball, it wasn't beach volleyball, it wasn't picnic volleyball. It was like 5 days a week in a gymnasium for 9 months of the year, volleyball, okay? And so, and Kelsey's a really intense person. You may not notice that now, but you get Kelsey on a volleyball court and she is just an animal. It just shows on her face. But I tell you that expression that I saw that really used to worry me, that worried me as a parent, you know, she wasn't happy, wasn't having fun. Ever since she met Brian, I haven't seen that expression. And so I thank Brian for that. So with that, I'd like to welcome Brian into our family.
Like chocolate fondue. She is a crowd favorite. I have introduced Kelsey to many friends over the years, and everyone always just falls in love with her. The next day, everyone is Facebook friends with her and is texting her, and they're besties. And some of my friends are here tonight because now they're friends with Kelsey.
Beautiful day today. It's a beautiful day for a celebration. And that's what today is, part celebration, part thanksgiving and rejoicing, part ceremony, part new beginnings.
Say what you're dying to say.
I was honored to have Brian and Kelsey ask me to officiate at their wedding. I married into the Campbell family, and I've assured Kelsey that it worked out wonderfully for me. Today, they will be announced, husband and wife. This is the wedding Brian and Kelsey hoped for, planned for, and look forward to.
Give me something to hold on to. More than just a feeling that it's true. 'Cause I can't wait, I can't wait.
On Thanksgiving Day, Brian asked Kelsey to take a walk with him in a favorite childhood park. Big white snowflakes fell. This is true, right? I'm not making this sound too romantic. Okay. Then he got down on a knee and asked her to marry him. A year of significant uncertainty stood between then and now. So they made a tough but mature decision. They took some of their army friends and visited a justice of the peace in Leesville, Louisiana. And they were married there 1 year ago this month.
Your eyes, shades of green and white, along the space we walk, there's a thin red line
Brian told me that selfless service is an army value, but that Kelsey exhibits it better than anyone he knows. Kelsey said Brian was pretty selfless too, happy to look out for friends, and that this was a quality she loved in him. She likes his dimples.
Kelsey, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
I give you this ring as a token.
I give you this ring as a token.
Of my committed and abiding love.
My committed and abiding love. Can never be wrong. I
know it's hard for you to say. Brian, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
May it always remind you.
May it always remind you.
That you are embraced.
That you are embraced.
By my enduring love for you.
By my enduring love for you.
Whenever you look at it.
Whenever you look at it.
You will remember me.
You will remember me.
This joyous day.
This joyous day.
And my promises to you.
And my promises to you. Baby, if you sure say. Baby, if you sure say
these three words. Brian and Kelsey, you are husband and wife. Brian, you may kiss your bride.
Me into ROTC. He decided to go to Army. I did the Air Force. I know Mario had a big part in that as well. But when I found out that's what he was doing, I was really proud of what he had and what he was attempting to accomplish there. Granted, he did join the Army, not the Air Force, so I do give him trouble about that. Spaces, hollow places, things you cannot mend, so you let go. He also did copy me by marrying a nurse. He also copied me and found a fantastic woman. The woman that he found, it fits him to a T. A more godly woman, a woman who puts a smile on his face, keeps him grounded, but still lets him have a good time every now and again as well. Would you disarm me?
I'd like to welcome Kelsey into our family as well. We're really, really blessed to have Kelsey, and it's been just a phenomenal couple days. All seeing old friends, seeing these two guys together, just thinking about their future ahead. What this soul feels, these words cannot complete. But you made spaces, hollow places, things I could not mend. So I let go,
and I let go. Kelsey just has this zest for life. And by zest for life, I mean Kelsey loves to scare the ever-living out of people. When my mom would come home from work, when we were in high school, Kelsey would yell, "Hide!" And she would hide behind the counter or in our pantry and wait for my poor mother to come walking in, and then she'd jump out and surprise her. Because who doesn't want that at the end of a day? And so, but I love that she does stuff like that all the time. Like the other day, all of a sudden she grabbed my butt and it scared me half to death. But I love that about her.
I was so proud of him when I saw him on the newscast on NBC. I had to take a moment and just reflect on that. It was just cool to see my brother out there on the ground in Afghanistan. It was just cool to see him and what he was doing there.
I think the best partners are partners that bring out the wonderful qualities that you already have. And I see that in Brian bringing out Kelsey's wholeheartedness. And I think Brian also lives so incredibly wholeheartedly. I knew that he was the right one.